signal to noise ratio in this case. But if I lay down and I play dead and I stay dead, maybe you'll get sick of being the monster out of my head under my bed. Hello, welcome to Rifki the Cyber. In this video, I would like to explain it to you how we can do the scanning the cell tower of the LTE 4G radio technology around your neighborhood. Maybe you think like this, I've seen similar video from you, Rifki, but this one I'm going to explain to you the difference is I'm going to scanning for the cell BTS tower for the high frequency. For example, if you are using this device, or we are using this device. This device only capable for scanning up to 1700, and this device only up to 2300. Well, in the practice, actually, somehow is not afford to scanning for the frequency 2300. In my region, we are using band FDD and band TDD. Band TDD is start band 39, but in my region, we are using band 40. You know, band 40, band 41, band 42, and band 43 in the cellular GSM. We talk about frequency 2300. We talk about frequency 2600. We talk about the frequency of 3000 MHz. Those BTS is really outnumber for the spec of this kind of this device. So what is the solutions? The solution is I'm going to use this device. This device can scanning up to 6 GHz. So if the LTE for the 4G radio technology, if they are using band 40, band 41, band 43, it doesn't matter. It can cover that frequency because it's up to 6 GHz. Those frequency in the actual BTS is maybe is up to 3000 something. But in my region, we are using around 2600 MHz and we are using 2300. Just for the back review again, why we need to scan? The purpose of scanning, there are two. First, site survey. Second, usually for the law enforcement or military, when they want to start the IMSI catching or the IMSI catcher activity, what they're gonna do is this device will start scanning the BTS around the neighborhood. And then when they catch the value or the data, then after that, they will start to broadcast by cloning the data one by one. So they try, so the machine itself try to be the more attractive BTS rather than the actual BTS itself. So what happen is the mobile phone will attach to that BTS fake, the IMC catcher stingray itself, and they will fetch the IMC. Back again to this HackRF that I'm going to use it. The spec of HackRF is around up to 6000 GHz. I'm going to show it to you how to do it. Rather than a lot of chatty, let's test together, guys. So what we're gonna do right now, so in my mobile phone right now, I'm going to check what is the frequency that use right now. It's very easy, just star hash 0011 hash, and I'm going to redirect that to this one. So this is the secret menu, basically. I'm going to the stack, so we can look at this one. So this is around 3,39250 or 3925 something like that, blah blah blah. I think this is discarded. Supposedly it's 2,39250 because this is TDD. The frequency uplink and downlink is the same. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm going to check with this 39250. So 39250, what is the frequency? So I'm using okay, and then I'm going to check what is the frequency here. So this is the frequency in the 2360 MHz. So it will be using 2360 until 0.0 MHz to 2360.8 MHz. So supposedly the cell search will catch this one. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to start this one. Whoops, there is an error, guys. That mean I need to use my HackRF. I need to plug this one, my HackRF. And then after that, I am going to connect my HackRF with this one. Connect HackRF one. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to start again. Still, there is some error. Why? Because the script is not using this one. We are going to using the different script, not cell search. The name is the cell search underscore HackRF. So let's see. So this is the actual script. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to scan this one. Okay, skip starting, and it will be stopped until the frequency that I dictate to be stopped in this case. Okay, it turned out that they found that this is using the TDD band. Is it correct, TDD? Correct, TDD band. I'm going to explain it to you how using what is the TDD. And then after that, the cell ID is 7. Is it correct? Let's go to here. Look at here. This is the PCI 7, which is correct. That means the cell itself is using 7. So this is the antenna number, antenna port, etc. This is the frequency. This is the crystal collection. And this is also the RX power. The question is how we can get this script. No worries, you don't need to install anything. What you're gonna do is you just using the operating system that already install all the utilities that using for the radio frequency. The name is Dragon Vocal. So credit for the guy who compiled it, one Semax executor. I'm going to put the link for you so you able to download the ISO file in the descriptions of this video. But guys, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share to others so everyone can enjoy what the knowledge that I have been shared in this case. Now, for the next step, we are going to make a measurement with the LTE script, other LTE script, right? We are going to monitor this one. So what we're gonna do, we are going to using another script in this case. Okay, so this one, so we are using LTE tracker 2360.0. This is megahertz, of course, minus I, zero. And then I just want to put like this. So we are going to start for example, tracking this frequency. Oh, there is some error. Of course, there is some error because I'm using the LTE script for the rtl-sdr. So this is going to be the same like before. I'm using for specifically for the HackRF One. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to use this one. So I just put HackRF. Then boom. Okay, this is already start to do some calibrating. Already got now. So we can see a lot of things here. You can also measure the signal to noise ratio in this case. So there are so many things that we can see from this one, guys. Yeah. The second thing, I promise you, what is the difference between the TDD that was reflected there and the FDD? For FDD, from the mobile phone to the BTS, they're using dedicated frequency. Let's say, for example, FDD using the frequency 1, 2, 3, 4 mobile phone towards to the BTS. So those channel will still open and remain constant open. From the BTS towards to the mobile phone is using 4, 5, 6. Those frequency is always open in the FDD. So they have a two different frequency open for the communication from the BTS, from the mobile phone towards to the BTS, and the BTS towards to the mobile phone. Unlike FDD, the TDD using same frequency. So how they arrange when the phone want to communicate to the BTS using the same frequency, the time itself, he's the one who do the orchestrating. Okay, now you talk and now you listen. And then after that, when the data reach, when the data communicate there, and also the timer will say, okay, you're going to talk and you are going to listen. So this is what we call it TDD. Same frequency, but it's alternating between the one who from the BTS towards to the phone and the phone towards to the BTS. Using same frequency, orchestrating using the timer. So I think everything already clear, hopefully useful. And as I always said in my other previous video, keep learning and stay humble.